Welcome to part six of Firewatch. So, this is the last leg of the game that I recorded. This game meant a whole lot to me. I'll explain why at the end of the video. So, please just enjoy the rest of the game, and we'll talk once it's done. So, I'll see you guys at the end of the video.
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Is this the Flapjack fire, or the site fire, or...?
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah, oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us, whoever made the tape.
Okay, yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was hoping you'd have a backup plan or something.
Yeah, okay, I'm probably gonna move to Canada. Ontario, maybe.
No, I meant if something happens to me.
Right, if you don't find out who made the tape and I have to hit the road.
Forget it.
Be safe, Henry.
We got a Cheez-It bucket.
Delilah, the path out here is blocked off.
There must have been a rock slide or something. Wait, holy shit, do you think someone did this?
No, Henry. I think that is what's called an act of God. Good thing they're lifting us out today, huh?
Yeah, good thing.
What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
All right, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north, far, past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
Someone left a rope for me to climb up. I'm down near the lake.
How do you know it's for you?
There's a tracking collar tied to it. Someone was leading me here. And there's another tape.
Oh my God, Henry.
Each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for croc's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and I ran out of books. But I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids, alright? Nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us just him.
Pat Goodwin. He made the tape?
Yeah. He's gone. Deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
He's got a survival bunker with radios and everything. He made it all up.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay. He had quite the view. He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that. He wrote down everything he did to us, and everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
I bet.
He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going. You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands. This boombox looks familiar.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say. We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
He... God.
What?
Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff. He held on to some of Brian's things, his wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he found it riveting.
Brian was a nice-looking kid.
Yeah.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site.
I know I should be relieved. Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not. He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
I think that Ned loved him. He still had his photo, you know?
I don't want to hear it.
He obviously didn't want to forget him. He just didn't know what to do.
Henry, not knowing what to do isn't okay. When you're supposed to look after someone,
you figure it out.
Yes. And Ned Goodwin is a shithead who is incapable of figuring anything out. Sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home. I can't stop thinking about it.
You'll let it go, and it'll be okay. It'll haunt you for a while, but eventually you'll look back and you'll be far enough away to forgive yourself.
Justify to myself, maybe.
Yeah, well, that's better than nothing.
And he'll still be down there in that cave, because if I say anything, they're gonna ask me about Ned.
D?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey! No, there's one more. Yes, here, yeah. Yeah, he's coming. Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
D. What if they don't come back for me?
They'll come back. That's their job.
Just what if we missed something about, something? I don't know.
Henry, you're tired. There's nothing big going on. They'll come back for you.
Just wait.
I'm gonna go.
Okay. If you have to.
I have to. Hike safe.
I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah? Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi. Yeah, it's me. I'm back at the staging area near the trailhead. I think I see your truck.
Red? Colorado plates?
Yeah. It's a piece of shit.
Hey, that's a man's pickup you're talking about.
I think there might be a raccoon living in it.
Make sure he's comfy, I guess.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
Okay.
There's a debrief in a situation like this. Lots of questions.
Ah, shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me and I'll choose for you?
All right, sure. Maybe... Well, you'd make a great shrink.
Are you kidding me? You spent 10 weeks with me, and God knows how much therapy it's going to take to undo this experience.
Well, you're a good conversationalist, I guess.
Thanks. I try.
I mean, you definitely still have some stuff to learn at shrink school. Like, a lot of stuff.
Noted.
So, what about me then?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I am. Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year, we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
No. Henry, you keep it for yourself, okay? Bye, Hank.
something told me it was over. Yeah. When I saw you and her talking, something deep down in my soul said, cry, girl. Watch you leave me, babe. Most of all, I just don't wanna be free, no. Walk away from me, yeah.
So that was the end of Firewatch. I'm going to try and explain why I liked this game so much without sounding like a bumbling idiot. So let's get started. The first reason I really liked it was because it told a story about people. Like, it wasn't a shooter game where you're a soldier. It wasn't like an RPG in a desolate wasteland. It wasn't anything like that. It was about a person who was relatable. He was just an average guy with average problems, and he took up a relatively normal job, and you get to experience what his life, at least for the summer, was like. Not a lot of games do that these days. They always like try and push the boundaries, which is, you know, that's cool, but it's also interesting to get a different perspective from a game. One where you're not doing all of that crazy stuff, but instead you're being an average person. So then the second reason is the setting was incredible. You're smack dab in the middle of nowhere. You're in the middle of Yellowstone National Park. And you're in this beautiful, beautiful area that was developed. And that's the whole setting. You're not going anywhere. You're not traveling anywhere else except this small map area. And yet it's incredible, and you get sucked into it. And finally, I like mystery games, and this was about a mystery. This was about fear, what it's like to be alone, what it's like to be isolated, and what that can actually do to you, what it can do to a person who is isolated. And his only contact was with Delilah, so he did have one person to talk to, but still, he was isolated, he was alone, and things started to go wrong, and he really had no one to help him in person. And so you get sucked into that. Like, what would you do if you were in his shoes? You also get to develop Henry as a person as you play. You get to decide what choices he made and what choices he keeps making, and ultimately his whole personality and how he interacts with people. And It was just really interesting to pair all of those into one game, into an indie game, and for it to be as excellent as it turned out. So that's why I enjoyed Firewatch so much. So that is the end of this gameplay. That's the end of the series, actually. They did release more content for the game, but it's really just a walkthrough telling you what the developers did during the whole creation of Firewatch. And I'm not going to do that because that's going to take forever. So I hope you enjoyed my Firewatch gameplay. If you did, please like and subscribe. That would really help my channel grow. And I'm going to be uploading Until Dawn next. I really want to finish that. And I have a few funny clips that I want to put together into a video from GTA, Call of Duty, whatever I was really playing. So with that all said and done, I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out.